ओके माय डियर स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू एडुस्क्रिप्शन। टुडे द फोर्थ एक्सपेरिमेंट इज योर अबाउट द पेल्टन व्हील टर्बाइन। एम ऑफ द एक्सपेरिमेंट टू स्टडी द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स एंड फाइंड आउट द एफिशिएंसी ऑफ ए पेल्टन व्हील टर्बाइन एंड द बेसिक अपैरेटस पेल्टन व्हील टर्बाइन टेस्ट रिग, टैकोमीटर एंड सम वेट्स। नेक्स्ट वी मूव फॉर द थ्योरी पार्ट। About the theory part, hydraulic turbines converts to hydraulic energy into mechanical energy. These are known as hydraulic motors or prime mover. The mechanical energy developed by a turbine is used in running an electric generator, which is directly coupled to the shaft of a turbine. The electric generator thus develops electric power, which is known as hydroelectric power. Turbines are classified into two types, impulse and reaction turbine. It is the turbine run by impulse of water, the water from a dam made to flow through a pipelines, then through the guide mechanism. So, what happen? And finally, when the jet of water issuing from the nozzle striking the bucket which are provided on the runner. Thus, the runner is rotated and the runner is keyed to a shaft and the shaft is coupled to a generator. That's why it will produce the electricity. Next part, about the different parts. Pelton turbine consists of a nozzle, that is a circular guide mechanism, which guides the water to flow at a designed direction. A conical needle known as spear operated inside the nozzle in an axial direction. It regulates the quantity of water flowing through the nozzle. The movement of a spear is regulated by manually. So a runner is consist of a circular disc with a number of bucket eventually spaced round in its periphery. The buckets are in the shape of double elliptical cup. So each bucket is divided into two symmetrical parts by a splitter. The jet of water impinging on the splitter gets divided into two equal portions and leaves the bucket with an angle of 165 degree. Next, we move for the machine. About the machines, this part is the motor. And motor, when motor will start, immediately vacuum is created in this end. So it will suck the water from the sump, then forcefully towards the venturimeter. This part is your venturimeter, and about the different parts of the venturimeter, this part is the converging, throat, diverging part. So when the water flow through this, automatically this is with high pressure. Then when it pass through the venturimeter, here it maintain a constant pressure. After that, another opening and closing valve also here. So when we open this valve, automatically that was rush towards here and goes through the nozzle path. Inside it, one nozzle path is here, one nozzle path is there. That water with high pressure, when we open this valve, automatically that water goes through this nozzle path. So here, in between this path, one spear is there. Now you just mark here, the upper pointed part is the spear, which is operated by this handle. Okay, and when we open this spear, automatically that water is converted with water jet and striking upon the bucket. That's why what happened? It was pressurized to rotate the shaft, which is connected with the bucket. This is the shaft, and the shaft is connected with the bucket. So automatically that bucket is rotated, and simultaneously the shaft is rotated with the same RPM. And similar way, that was connected here, one sensor is there. That's why what happen, it will show the RPM here. the speed of the shaft. Another part is this is the brake drum. This is basically for laboratory purpose, through which this is the rope arrangement. Here we give your weight, and the opposite part is this is your spring weight. So from this two, dead weight and spring weight, we find out the torque. Similar way, this part is when we open this, automatically water will supply to cool this brake drum. This is the total arrangement. And when the shaft is rotated, that was connected with another generator, then it will produce the electricity. So this is the basic thing of a turbine. Before starting, first you know the governing formula. Efficiency is your brake power divided by input power into 100. So brake power is your 2 pi n t divided by 60,000, and input power is your W q h. So in this brake power, T is the torque. For calculation of torque, W1 and W2, so W1 is the dead weight and W2 is the spring balance weight. Re is the effective radius. Effective radius is your dia of the rope and half dia of the brake drum divided by 2. By applying that formula, we find out the effective radius, and putting that value, that another part is the N. So initially we adjust that N, it maintain a constant RPM. N is the RPM of the shaft, speed of the shaft. So next part is the input part. Input part is the WQH. W is the specific weight of the water, Q is the discharge. So in your tabulation part, it is a vital thing is Q. In pump also, we find out the discharge, that is your A into H by T. But here, in case of turbine, that Q is equal to K into root over of H. So here, K is the venturi constant. When water flow through the venturi meter, so we take that venturi constant, K is equal to A1 into A2, root over of 2GH divided by A1 the square minus A2 the square. And that's value is your 3.251 into 10 to the power minus 3. And H is the, so initially when we take the reading, we find out the pressure, P1 and P2. P1 is the inlet pressure. When water flow through the venturi meter, the converging part, so we find out the inlet pressure and find out the throat pressure. That was in the front panel. From that front panel, we find out P1 and P2. Similar way, this is your P1 and this is your P2. This is indicate the converging pressure and this is throat pressure. So from this two, we find out H is equal to P1 minus P2 into 10. That's why we find out the meter of a, that is constant head. Another H is equal to turbine head. Turbine head is your, this is the turbine head. Already that head is equal to HS plus HD, suction head plus delivery head. But here suction and delivery in a same path, so we maintain this turbine head directly. Next part, we may go for the operation part. Now, before starting, switch on the power supply and all the pressure gauges in closed position, this valve also closed position. Now, give the power supply here. Next, slowly open the valve. for that to maintain this RPM up to 1000, to maintain this RPM up to 1000, maximum 1000. Suppose you take 5 observation, then all the observation should 1000. After that,
also we find out the pressure individually, inlet pressure and throat pressure. Also collect the data of the net supply head, total head is your like this. So these are the tabulation parts, and in each observation you maintain the constant RPM, that is your 1000. After that, this is your tabulation part. Net break weight, simple input here like this, output like this, efficiency like this. Next we move for the calculation part. For finding out the efficiency, basic formula is your break power by input power, and the break power is your 2 pi mt by 60,000. Input power is your WQH. Then you put the value of the observation 1, 2, 3, 4 like this, and finally the conclusion part is you studied the different parts and function of a Pelton wheel turbine and find out its efficiency is 61.73 like this. Thank you.